Hello everyone, welcome to the info channels. Today I will discuss the requirement for the security supervisor position as well as the job description, duty and the responsibility of the security guard supervisor. The supervisor responsibility can be the different according to the nature of the business. For example, the hotel security supervisor responsibility can be different from the mall security supervisor. And the residence building security supervisor duty can be the difference from the production company security supervisor. However, here are the general duty and the responsibility of all type of security supervisor. When you know the duty and the responsibility, it helps you to face the interview because most of the questions come from it. On the other hand, knowing the description of the particular role help you to perform your duty when you are selected for that role. Now let's talk about the requirement for the security supervisor. Okay, to be the security supervisor, here are some requirements you should meet. At least 2 years experience in the security field or the similar role. Good communication skill. Diligent working attitude plus good coordination ability. Active and enthusiastic, should have the basic knowledge of firefighting skill, motivated with a strong sense of the initiative, confidence and independent, duty and the responsibility of the security supervisor. Number one, supervise and guide the security officer behavior. As a security supervisor, you should monitor the activities of your team members in the grounds and instruct them on the proper way to interact with the visitor, vendors, and the employees. Number two, maintaining daily record. On the daily basis, you may need to prepare the different type of report at your workplace, such as incident report, accident report, and the security breaches report. You should know how to write the report and whom to submit it. Number three, familiar with the location of all major facilities, such as room and exit. Without a complete knowledge of the site, you cannot expect your team to carry out their responsibility effectively. Therefore, you should be familiar with the overall design of the site. Number four, regularly patrol and spot check premises. On the daily basis, you should conduct the patrol all area of the site to know how the security guard are performing their duty, including the function room, public area, outlets, and surrounding area. Number five, assisting security manager to handle incident. Security supervisor is the right hand of the security manager. You should give the information and some idea to handle with the incident to the security manager, because you may know better than the security manager about the particular incident that has occurred. Number six, conduct emergency response drill, daily physical hazard and safety inspection, investigate and interview. Every business or the organization has a security policy that include an emergency drill. An emergency drill is a rehearsal in which all the employee and a visitor practice what to do in an emergency. Depending on the company, the drill may take place once a month or every 3 months. You are responsible for conducting the drill during the non-emergency situation. Each day, you should inspect the safety and security hazard. If an incident occurs, you should investigate and collect the witnesses' statement. Number seven, monitor closed circuit television and alarm system. The security supervisor must have the general understanding of the security system installed in their facility, including CCTV and alarm system. Your responsibility is to monitor the system to ensure they are working properly and to detect any unauthorized activities. Number eight, assist guest employee during the emergency situation. You are the leader of the evacuation of building during the emergency situation. Therefore, you should assist those people who are in the danger zone because you are the familiar with the escape route, exit doors, and their function. Number nine, gather information and complete the report and maintain the confidentiality. You can gather the information by coordinating with the security personnel and employees. Once you find the unlawful behavior, you must write a report. Making the report is not important. To keep it secretly is critical. So you must maintain the confidentiality of the report. Number 10, diffuse disturbance in accordance with the company policy and procedure. If a disagreement arises between the security personnel and employees or between the security personnel and the visitor, you must resolve it according to the company policy. Number 11, handle all the interruption and complaint. If a customer or the employee make a complaint, you should address it appropriately and without escalating the situation. Try to find the acceptable solution. You can consult with the department that relates the issue. Number 12, escort unwelcome persons from the property. If the unauthorized person enters into the premises, you should escort him or her until they out from the building. Number 13, assist management in training. You can work with the management team to schedule the training for the security personnel and other employees. Which type of training they need, you should recommend that. Number 14, motivating and coaching the employees. You should motivate the employee and encourage them to follow the company policy and the procedure. Inform them what is the important point while they are on duty and help them to develop the positive attitude toward their job and themselves. Number 15, answering the telephone using the appropriate language. When you are answering the call, maintain a courteous and polite tone. Avoid speaking as if you are ordering to them. Number 16, develop and maintain the positive working relationship with others. It is critical to maintain the positive relationship among team members. As a supervisor, you should encourage your team to put their differences aside and work toward a common goal. Not only should you play the role of the security personnel, but you should also play the role of managing the positive work relationship with other employees. If there is an issue that jeopardizes the interpersonal relationship, you should try to resolve it as soon as possible. Number 18, support team to reach a common goal. Listen to and respond appropriately to the other employees' concern while emphasizing the job objective. Number 18, risk assessment of the asset. Each work environment contains the danger. You should conduct a risk assessment and ensure that appropriate preventive measures are in place to avoid the incident. Number 19, visually inspect tool, equipment, or machine. The technology used in the company can become a hazard. You should inspect the equipment to ensure it is free of defect. When you discover the fault, you should contact the technician or other appropriate party to fix it. Number 20, police liaison. As a security supervisor, you should coordinate with the public authority such as police and law enforcement officer to facilitate the investigation if the incident requires the additional investigation. These are the duty and the responsibility of the security supervisor in the private security industry. I hope you have understanding. Thank you guys for watching the video. If you think this video is helpful, share to your friends. If you are new for this channel, don't forget to subscribe because I will make the video like this in future. You will not miss to watch. Bye for now.